Hello, good afternoon, friends. Last class, we just had an overview of the entire final year subjects that we have. And we just went through the details of mechatronics syllabus to some extent. Today, we'll discuss a few more details about the introductory part of mechatronics. So, friends, as we know, the syllabus for mechatronics, I already put it on Google Classroom even. Now, this syllabus has got 6 units. As you can see, the first unit will be having introductory part of subject mechatronics. What are the practical examples of mechatronic systems that we'll be discussing? Thereafter, we'll study some of the sensors and transducers required in the mechatronic systems. We'll be discussing some temperature sensors, temperature transducers, pressure transducers, force transducers, some proximity sensors, some optical encoders, and some tactile sensors as well. So in this unit one, we'll be having brief introduction and brief study of sensors and transducers. In second unit, we'll be having signal conditioning and data representation. Here, whatever signal we'll be getting from the sensors and transducer, how it is modified, how it is conditioned, so as to make it suitable for the actuating elements. So all these signal conditioning devices will be studied to some extent. Some operational amplifiers will be studying, some opto-isolators, some A to D converters, and some D to A converters, and we'll be studying some of the relays also. And some data representation systems will be studying in this unit. Types of displays and some data logging systems and data acquisition systems will be studying. In unit number 3, as you can see, we have sensed the signal, we have conditioned the signals. Now, the actuating elements, the types of drives, we'll be studying here in unit number 3. So in this unit, we'll be studying some electrical motors, particularly AC and DC motors, DC servo motors we'll be studying, and some types of linear motors and stepper motors we'll be studying as part of electrical drives. And in the second part of unit number 3, we'll be studying some hydraulic and pneumatic actuating devices. We'll be studying different hydraulic circuits, different pneumatic circuits, how these circuits are made suitable for our automation applications. Let it be a machine tool, let it be a robo, whatever pick and place device I have. So for that, how to design a hydraulic or pneumatic circuit and how to make it functional. So all these aspects we'll be studying in this unit number 3. Unit number 4, as you can see, we'll be studying some microprocessor and microcontrollers. So in particular, we'll be having an overview of 8085 microcontroller. Its architecture we'll be studying. What are the types of registers and their functions we'll be studying. Some instruction sets, interfacing, how interfacing is done, and what are the applications of this 8085 microprocessor that we'll be studying briefly. The second part of unit number 4 will be studying 8051 microcontroller, its architecture, its instruction sets, various pins and their functions, how interfacing is done, that will also be studied, and some applications of this microcontroller will be studied. And finally, in this unit number 4, we'll be studying some programmable logic controllers. Here also, we'll be studying its architecture, what are the various inputs and outputs of this PLC, what are the specifications, how to select PLCs, how to do programming, what is ladder logic, and what is functional block diagram for PLC. So these aspects we will be studying in unit number 4. In unit number 5, we'll be studying some control systems, some open loop and closed loop control systems we'll be studying, and what is meant by block diagram, what is meant by block diagram algebra, what are the manipulation or reduction rules of block diagrams, that also we'll be studying in this first part of unit number 5. And secondly, thereafter, we'll be studying how to construct, how to mathematically model various mechanical elements that we'll be studying and how to find out the transfer functions of these systems that we'll be studying. In mechanical elements, we'll be studying typical spring mass dashpot systems we'll be studying, and what are their equivalents, that also we'll be studying in this unit number 5. And finally, in unit number 6, friends, we'll be studying stability of the systems, and here we'll be studying various types of controllers. Briefly, we'll be understanding what is the on-off controller or two-position controller, what is the proportional controller, what is an integral controller, what is the derivative controller, and plus thereafter we'll be studying what is PI, that is proportional plus integral controller, what is proportional plus derivative controller, and what is proportional plus integral plus derivative controller, that is PID controller. And finally, we'll be studying some state variable system models, and we'll understand the construction methodology of the Bode plots, and how to find out the stability of a given control system. So this is how we'll be having 6 units. And as I discussed in the last class even, we have to be attentive, we have to be regular in our classes, because each of the units are linked with the other units. So you should not skip any of the classes. And this is a bit different subject in a sense. We'll be having some mechanical engineering knowledge will be requiring, some electrical engineering knowledge also will be requiring, some electronics engineering knowledge also will be requiring. And we'll try to understand each of the units in details slowly. And the books, those are recommended as per the DY2 syllabus. Remember, many of the books are available with us. First book I recommend to our students is W. Bolton's book on mechatronics. I have put the soft copy of this book on our Google Classroom. So try to enroll our Google Classroom as early as possible, so that all the material will be made available on this Google Classroom of final year mechanical engineering students. And I'll be providing the links to various lectures we'll be conducting. So as you all know, we have a YouTube channel as well by the name AGPIT e-learning. There all the videos will be available, and the link for those videos will be provided in our Google Classroom. So the textbook recommended is Bolton's book. Number of copies are available in the library. But remember, this being a bit different subject, right from day one, you have to be attentive, start taking out notes. No doubt, I'll be providing all the resource material in our Google Classroom, but you need to read all these notes properly, because ha gappa maraja vishayam hai, you should have specific knowledge of various units, and then only you'll be able to solve the questions related to mechatronics. Then you have a book from HMT titled Mechatronics. This also is available in our library. And thirdly, this F.H. Raven's book on automatic control, which is also a very good book, for particularly for unit number 5 and unit number 6. We have number of Xerox copies of this book available in our library. So you can refer. I'll be definitely giving you when to use these notes, for which unit we need to use these notes. This particular Raven's book will be useful for unit number 5 and unit number 6 specifically. And for rest of the units, this Bolton's book should be sufficient. Most of my PPTs are based on Bolton's book only. And if you want Indian author's book, Rajput's book is available in our library, a textbook on mechatronics. This is too bulky and too descriptive. If you, for a particular topic, if you are not understanding some concepts, you can always refer Rajput's book. This Alciator, this book is also available in our library, but it is a bit difficult to understand, but it is available in our library. This Bradley's book, we are trying to make it available in our library. We ordered for this. But I think regarding books, you need not worry. This, as I told you, this Bolton's book, soft copy, I have already put on our Google Classroom, and hard copies or hardcover copies, are number of copies are available in our library. And Raven's book, Xerox, is number of copies are available. So as far as books are concerned, you need not worry. As far as laboratory work is concerned, you know, you have the oral exam for this subject. So you need to have around 8 to 9 assignments you have to write. Few practicals we need to do. Practicals particularly related to electrical motors, practicals related to pneumatics and hydraulics. We have the trainers available, trainer kits available in our laboratory. We'll be providing you those material. In fact, one lab manual I have already uploaded on our Google Classroom. And one sample journal also probably I have uploaded in our Google Classroom. You can start writing a blank journal, no problem. As and when the assignments will be given to you, you need to upgrade those assignments. Plus, we'll be having some experiments on microprocessor, microcontroller, and PLC. And this will be done with the help from Professor Ligade sir from ENTC department. They've got number of trainer kits of microprocessor and microcontroller and PLC even. So last time he had already conducted 4 to 5 experiments on simple, based on simple applications. And those also will be covering. So microprocessor kits will be using, microcontroller kits will be using, and programmable logic controller kits also will be using. Then we have one process control unit for temperature control. So one experiment on this also will be conducting. So this is as far as mechatronics lab is concerned. And as far as evaluation, but DBAR2 is concerned, let us try to understand. For theory, we'll be having continuous assessment wherein you'll be given assignments, and there will be CA1 and CA2 and some quizzes I'll be keeping. So based on all these assignments and tests, you'll be allocated 20 marks. So writing the assignments is must, writing the tests is must. Without that, you cannot get these marks out of 20. Then you'll be having mid-semester exam, over 20 marks after around 45 to 50% coverage of syllabus. Of course, this will be as per guidelines of DBAR2. And then finally, you'll be having end semester exam of 60 marks. So in all, 100 marks are allocated for the theory part. And for laboratory work, for term work, writing journals, for assignments based on laboratory work, you'll be given 30 marks out of 30. And then you have end semester examination, that is oral exam, for 20 marks. So this is how 50 marks for this lab work and 100 marks for theory work. This is how the evaluation of mechatronics subject will be done. So let us start with the introduction part of mechatronics system. Friends, if you look around, any of the gadgets nowadays is, in my opinion, a mechatronics gadget. Take watch, take your mixer, take kitchenware, take your refrigerator, take washing machine, take a microwave oven, or consider the case of CNC machines. Now we don't have purely mechanical devices, purely electrical devices. Most of the devices are coupled with electronic controls. So if you take the case of any of the gadgets we come across, you will be having inclusion of mechatronics in it. So it has become a buzzword now. So understanding the concepts of mechanical engineering as well as electronics engineering, and plus some knowledge of control engineering and some knowledge of computer engineering. This is what makes the subject of mechatronics engineering very interesting. Let us see closely what is the definition of mechatronics. Mechatronics is a synergistic combination. What is synergistic? Manje ka ekmekamadhe merge honare, ekjeev honare. Is the synergistic combination of mechanical engineering, that is mecha corresponds to mechanisms. It's a synergistic combination of mechanical engineering, electronics engineering, so tronics part from mechatronics, and mecha part of mechanisms. This is how the term mechatronics is formed. But it is a synergistic combination of mechanical engineering, electronics engineering, control engineering, and computer engineering. This is how mechatronics is defined. The word mechatronics was first coined by a Japanese person, Tetsuro Moriya, a senior engineer of the Japanese company Yasakawa. It was coined in the year way back in 69, and thereafter, now it has emerged as a new branch of engineering wherein there will be amalgamation, mixing of all the disciplines. So it's a multidisciplinary course. So you need to have knowledge of almost variety of fields, most of the fields. So if you are trying to develop a mechatronics device for surveying application, so you need to have knowledge of civil engineering subjects as well. So only thing is that, what is the parametric requirement for surveying? What are the parameters those are to be measured? And how those are measured conventionally? And how I can build one mechatronic device for getting the measurement that I get from surveying equipment. Just as an example, I'm telling you. So we know many applications commonly, the washing machine that we talk about. Nowadays, most of the washing machines are microcontroller controlled. As you can see, you have a keyboard or a keypad on the console of a washing machine. And you need to just provide your washing parameters, what kind of washing you want, whether you want a rough washing or heavy washing, light washing, depending on type of the clothes, whether I have got two dirty clothes or cotton clothes, rough clothes, if I have got shawl or woolen cloth, what kind of wash I want. So it is very clearly specified in the controller module, and accordingly, all those programs are already fed in the microcontroller that is embedded in that washing machine. And we have to just start, run the program, and the entire wash cycle, let it be of 20 minutes, let it be of 40 minutes, let it be of 1 hour, that entire wash cycle is executed. You must have observed that once you start your wash cycle, initially the water and the detergent is allowed to get into the tank, mixing tank, and thereafter, whether you want hot water, what degree temperature you want hot water, accordingly, the predefined quantity of water and predefined proportion of detergent is mixed together, and it is it enters into the drum of the washing machine where the clothes are wetted, and thereafter, that mixture is stirred along with the clothes, and depending upon, if you want to have a heavy wash, then the clockwise and anti-clockwise torque is applied accordingly, and the number of cycles of forward clockwise rotations and anti-clockwise rotations, those can also be pre-programmed. You can increase or decrease the number of twists, right? There is something called as a tumbler wash also. So all these features can be included in that washing machine, and thereafter, after 30 minutes, when the cloth, the wash cycle is over, then the rinse cycle starts. Upon saga rinsing of clothes, that the saga detergent nikun java manun, just additional water is provided, and all the soap and the soap foam, all those dirt, everything is drained out, and thereafter, finally, spinning is done. Partially, the clothes are dried. With the centrifugal force, all the water will be drained out, and after completion of that wash cycle, I have maybe 40 minutes wash cycle. Now, this is how that washing machine works. Now, the devices in this washing machine are, the motor is the drive element, the tumbler and whatever belt or gear drives we are providing, those are the mechanical elements, various valves used are mechanical elements, and then the controller is electronic device, isn't it? So in high end washing cycles, you can have the present generation washing machines, you can control that machine sitting in your office even. So an app can be developed by making use of your software knowledge, and that app is linked with the washing machine controller, and from here, sitting in your office, you can execute that wash cycle. For that matter, not just washing machine, any of the devices, you can be staying maybe 1,000 kilometers away from your home, but still from there, I can operate the air conditioner, washing machines, or whatever devices I have, refrigerator, remotely I can control. So here, what I'm trying to tell you is that such applications have have inclusion of mechanical engineering knowledge, electronics engineering knowledge, control engineering knowledge, and computer engineering knowledge, right? So this is what is mechatronics briefly. And if you just try to see a diagram, you'll understand how many branches are merged into the branch of mechatronics engineering. So you have this circle, you have electromechanics, electronic systems, and control electronics. This is one circle. Then in control engineering, I have digital control system and control electronics. This is one circle. And then mechanical systems, mechanical CAD, electromechanics, and mechanical system design. This is one circle. And computers, digital control system, and mechanical CAD. So this is a computer circle. So the intersection of all those four circles is a branch called as mechatronics. So what are the application areas? Of course, we'll see the application areas briefly later on. Name the field you have got mechatronics applications, aerospace applications, medical applications, aerography, defense systems, consumer products, manufacturing, materials processing, and automotive. So in almost all the fields, you'll find mechatronics devices. Now, this is the block diagram for mechatronic element strengths. If you just see, you have the actuators, wherein I can have actuators in the form of solenoids, in the form of DC motors, in the form of DC motors, in the form of stepper motors, in the form of servo motors, in the form of hydraulic actuators or pneumatic actuators. So from the actuators, let us try to understand what happens is, let us say I have an example of a CNC machine tool, let us say. What happens in the CNC machine tool? We write the program for maybe a turning operation. Some three-step turning is to be done. I have the simulator and I have the drawing of the part to be manufactured, the raw material details I have got. Accordingly, I write the program and I execute the program. And the machine tool over the spindle motor GI that can be controlled for adjusting the machining speed or the spindle speed. Then I have got tool post where the tool can be monitored. There's a lead screw wire that is driven through an electric motor that gives forward motion and backward motion, and the rate at which the tool post can move can be programmed, can be controlled. Okay, mug actually surface finish study, I can have one sensor, and the positional sensor will just ensure whether the required dimension is achieved or not. So dimensional control sensors are there. So the sensors, sagle, they'll be giving feedback to the controller. And the controller kaya bagna step turning of 125 205, right? And then step turning in second step, step turning of 120 to 85, and third step is 120 raw material size to 60 size. Manje maakada 180 ani 60 diameters che teen steps ahet. Hi maje ek rough requirement hai asa samjhe. Ma tyacha sathi spindle madhe job lavlela hai. The spindle speed can be controlled. The tool which is carrying out this step turning application operation, its motion can be controlled. Ani vegvegle sensors je can measure the dimensions till the required dimensions are attained. Ashi ek system hai asa samjhe apan. Ma ya case madhe let us say the spindle speed, as the spindle motor is one of the actuators. That can be a DC motor. Okay, that can even be an AC motor whose speed can be controlled. That can be, if it is a small machine, it can be a stepper motor. But for heavy duty machine motors, heavy duty machine tools, CNC machine tools, I go in for the AC motors or DC motors whose speed is controlled. Okay, so in this case of CNC machine tool, actuator is a DC motor, let us say. My sensors kutle kutle vapanar apan ya CNC step turning application madhe. I'll be having sensor for measuring the forward and backward motion of my tool post. Okay, ita mayakade optical encoder asel or optical sensor asel which will measure the forward and backward motion of my tool post. Okay, to ek sensor hai, position sensor asel. Diameter measure karnara ek sensor asu shake. which will measure the diameter, original raw material diameter, and when machining झाल्यानंतर what is the reduced diameter. So diameter sensors, then I have got position sensors. I can always have a speed sensor for measuring the speed of the spindle, isn't it? So that will be the sensor transducer part. Okay, let us take one more example. Ki baba mala tool post ji hai tya job cha end pasun, job cha jo face aahe, let us call that position as zero position of x axis. Okay, but tithun mala I have the length of the job to be turned is maybe 100 millimeter. Okay, so in x direction I have to, the tool post has to start from zero position to 100 position. Okay, so end positions are 0 and 100. Okay, so there the position sensors, as the tool post moves, the position sensors will give the feedback to the controller. Mag 10 millimeter position change halyanantar it has reached 10 millimeter. So out of 100 millimeter 10 is covered, so what is the error remaining? 90 millimeter is to be traversed further. Accordingly the linear motor will be given feed. Mag kutparyant chalu rahnar aahe till the 100 millimeter length of the turn part is covered, till that this control cycle will move on. So sensor transducers, those can be potentiometers aplya ya case madhe lechcha baptit. So potentiometers will give me the position of my tool post. So likewise for different applications I'll be having different types of sensors and transducers. Mahe je sense signal ahe that needs to be conditioned, mhanje the sense signal can be weaker, that needs to be conditioned, that can be amplified by using signal conditioning devices. Okay, my amplifiers I can use. Mukte signal samjha, if it is in the form of analog signal ani maza control loop jo hai, that is a digital control loop, mag that analog signal is needed to be converted into digital signal, mag I need to use A to D converter. Filters for filtering unwanted or noise signals, त्यासाठी filters वापरतो. Discrete circuits जे वापरणार आपण ते particularly digital control system मध्ये आपण वापरणार, then I will be using A to D converter or I will use D to A converter. This is a printing mistake. So digital to analog converter or analog to digital controller based on my requirement. मग काय काय झालं, actuation जे actually व्हायला लागलेलं आहे ते पॅरामीटर्स मी सेन्स करणार, तेच पॅरामीटर्स मी ऍम्प्लिफाय करणार, मॉडिफाय करणार, इम्प्रूव्ह करणार, कंडिशन करणार, आणि ते इम्प्रूव्ड सिग्नल आहे दॅट विल गो टू माय कंट्रोलर. दॅट कॅन बी आयदर एन अनलॉग कंट्रोलर ऑर कॅन बी अ डिजिटल कंट्रोलर. इट कॅन बी अ मायक्रो कंट्रोलर, इट कॅन बी अ पीएलसी ऑर एनी ऑफ द कंट्रोलर. माझा पी आय डी कंट्रोलर असू शकेल किंवा पी कंट्रोलर असू शकेल, पी प्लस आय कंट्रोलर असू शकेल. सो दॅट कंट्रोलर will receive that modified signal, compare it with the set value, and accordingly the output signal will be generated by the controller. Okay, so the output signal conditioning and interfacing is required. May je mala samjha, for that example of lathe machine, maji present position 10 millimeter la hai, ajun mala 90 millimeter jayla pahije, so the error signal corresponding to 90 millimeter traverse that is required will be generated. इक्वेलंट मिलीमीटरचं सिग्नल नाही जनरेट करणार तो, त्याला इक्वेलंट इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल मला द्यावं लागेल ड्राईव्ह मोटरसाठी. ओके, करस्पॉन्डिंग टू 90 मिलीमीटर दॅट इज टू बी कवर्ड. मग ते जे कंडिशन सिग्नल आहे, दिस आउटपुट सिग्नल कंडिशनिंग, दिस सिग्नल विल बी मेड अप्रोप्रिएट. जरी माझं ऍक्च्युअल सिग्नल काय आहे, पोझिशन सिग्नल आहे, 90 मिलीमीटरचा मला अजून टर्निंग कम्प्लीट करायचं आहे, सो डिस्टन्स ऑफ 90 मिलीमीटर इज टू बी कवर्ड. मग त्याला ते समजा लीड स्क्रू अरेंजमेंट आहे, 90 मीटर मिलीमीटर कव्हर करण्यासाठी डिपेंडिंग ऑन द पिच ऑफ द लीड स्क्रू अँड नट, किती रोटेशन्स मला ड्राईव्ह मोटरला द्यायला लागतील, त्या लीड स्क्रू मोटरला द्यायला लागतील, सो दॅट 90 मिलीमीटर विल बी कव्हर्ड. मग हे कोण करणार, ते अप्रोप्रिएट सिग्नल विल बी जनरेटेड बाय माय आउटपुट सिग्नल कंडिशनिंग डिवाइस. मग त्याला करस्पॉन्डिंग मे बी 100 पल्सेस आर नीडेड टू बी गिव्हन टू द स्टेपर मोटर विच इज ड्रायव्हिंग the lead screw. 100 pulses to generate karna, so the 100 pulses will be given to the actuating device of that lead screw stepper motor. Mag he kutpar kadhi paryant chalu rahnar, till that 100 millimeter is completed. Sir, 90 millimeter paryant ala, another 10 millimeter is to be required. Mag once again the actual position will be sensed by the sensor transducer, will be conditioned, it will be processed, आणि पुन्हा मग 10 millimeter इक्वॅलंट जे काही इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल पाहिजे माझ्या लीड स्क्रू मोटरला ते पुन्हा जनरेट होईल. मग दिस सायकल विल कंटिन्यू टिल द एरर इन दॅट पोझिशन बिकम झिरो, राईट. आणि इन द मेन टाइम हे कंट्रोल लूप चालू आहे माझं, मला काही काही डिस्प्लेस पाहिजे, मला प्रेझेंट पोझिशन जे आता आपण समजा टूल ट्रॅव्हर्सिंगचं जर उदाहरण घेतलं, सध्याची पोझिशन टूलची काय आहे, फ्रॉम झिरो फेस पासून झिरो आहे, इट हॅज रीच 10 millimeter, आय कॅन ऑलवेज हॅव द ग्राफिकल डिस्प्लेज, माझी LCD डिस्प्ले असेल विच विल शो मी द पोझिशन, इट हॅज रीच 10 millimeter, इट हॅज रीच 20 millimeter, इट हॅज रीच 100 millimeter, वॉट एव्हर इज माय रिक्वायरमेंट. मग द डिस्प्ले एलिमेंट्स डू दॅट वर्क ऑफ डिस्प्लेईंग द कंट्रोल पॅरामीटर. आणि कंट्रोल लूप काय करणार, कंप्लीट ते मशीनिंग सायकल टू माय डिझायर्ड लेवल कंप्लीट होईपर्यंत ती लूप कंटिन्युअसली चालत राहणार. सो दिस इज ब्रीफली हाऊ वी विल बी स्टडींग व्हेरियस एलिमेंट्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन अ मेकॅट्रॉनिक सिस्टीम. आता मी जस्ट तुम्हाला एक उदाहरण सांगितलं ते लेथ मशीनचं, असंच रोबो सिस्टीमसाठी आपण उदाहरण अंडरस्टँड करू शकतो. बट व्हेरियस मेकॅट्रॉनिक डिव्हायसेस वी कॅन आयडेंटिफाय वॉट आर द ॲक्च्युएटर्स, वॉट आर द सेन्सर्स, वॉट आर द ट्रान्सड्युसर्स, what are the signal conditioning devices, what are the control devices, what are the output control conditioning devices, what are the types of displays. So we'll be carrying out studies of various elements involved in the mechatronic system. I think friends, we'll stop for today.